this is Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, and thank you for tuning into this video. I want to take a minute here to talk to you about real estate safety. You know, it's really sad, but we just recently had an Arkansas realtor that was kidnapped and later murdered. Now, this does happen to the public as well on occasion, but very, very rarely. But nonetheless, it really strikes our hearts when this tragedy happens. And you don't normally think of this as happening in the real estate industry, but it can happen in the real estate industry. And so what that really means is that everybody has to take precautions. You, if you are a buyer or a renter looking at property, if you're a seller, my goodness gracious, if you're selling your home, particularly if you're selling your home solo, going it for sale by owner, and of course, we, the real estate community, the realtors involved, we need to take it more seriously and be more careful about how we conduct our business. So let me begin with talking to you about we've had these different incidences that have happened, and we even had one time a couple that actually posed, husband and wife posed as a real affluent type of couple, went from one part of the town to another part of the town, basically, you know, trying to, you know, rip off those particular properties, and of course, you know, causing harm to the realtors who showed those properties or to the people who are selling those properties themselves directly. We've actually seen this, of course, in the case sometimes of auto sales. This happens more frequently when it's a house and they're going inside a house rather than outside when they're just looking at a car, because the crime can be concealed when it's inside, generally as a rule. So, you know, it's really, really important to take precautions here. So let me first begin by talking to you if you're thinking about selling your home. Now, we have a lot of people who try to sell their homes themselves. We call those folks for sale by owners. And we understand in the realtor community why you want to do that. You're looking to save a buck. Okay, we get that there. But if you're going to do this, use the buddy system. So let me just say, if you're going to be showing the property to anybody, if you're going to be holding an open house, for heaven's sakes, have two adults there. Have two adults there. And maybe one of you is leading the way, perhaps to show the buyers or the prospective buyers the home, and the other one is picking up the rear end. So, you know, so that you have some control. But definitely use a buddy system kind of situation, and get rid of the kids. Have the kids leave. Don't have the kids around when you're showing this property to strange people. If you're going to hold an open house type of situation, just don't do that. You don't know whether somebody's coming in there to really just case your place, or if they might cause you bodily harm. It does indeed happen. One of the things you can do is certainly learn to ask the appropriate questions. Now, I know that if you're selling your home yourself, you don't like to ask a lot of questions because you think it's going to scare a prospective buyer away. Well, too bad. Learn to ask those kinds of questions. And if you really can't do that, ask the qualifying questions, then maybe you really just should not take the risk of selling these homes yourself and employ the services of a professional realtor. And like I said before, also think about doing an open house. When you do an open house, make sure you employ at the very least a buddy system. Maybe make sure your best friend knows that you're holding an open house and to give you a call periodically while you're holding that open house. Now, if you're a buyer or a potential renter looking at buying or renting property, you need to be aware of fraud and scams out there. We have a host of them today. You can find them all over the place. We got people that are actually advertising properties that they don't even own, or it's not even their listing, but they find the property to be vacant, and then they'll go ahead and sort of set you up to seemingly see that property or drive by, just send us some money. That's a big fraud and scam situation that we have going on, and that's just part of the doing business on the internet. So what can you do if you are a buyer or a renter and you're going at this again solo, meaning you're not represented by any realtor involved or you haven't contacted a property management company? Number one, ask the realtors for a copy of their their professional license. We call them a pocket card, and this is what in Colorado we get a pocket card that looks something like this, and we can show you that as far as identification is concerned, so that you know that legitimately we are a licensed realtor, whether we're selling real estate or conducting property management. That will definitely go a long way to prove to you who we are. Plus, you can visit the government website, DORA, DORA.colorado.gov, and you can check out our licensing right there, whether we are actually on license with the state of Colorado. And also, if you are thinking about renting or buying a property, particularly from the owner or the seller of the property direct, absolutely, unequivocally, check out who really owns that property there. Now, you can go ahead and go to the assessor's records there and check to make sure that those people, in fact, are the lawful owners. You got to admit, there's nothing worse than you putting down a deposit, whether it be for a security deposit or an earnest money deposit, only to find out that, oh, you just gave this nice big check to somebody who doesn't even have any legal rights to enter into a contract to sell or rent that property. So go ahead and go to the assessor's office for in whichever county that property is located in and look up the records to see that that person or those people do indeed actually own that property there. Now, if you're the realtor on it, please, please, my fellow colleagues, let's all be very, very careful here. Here's my take on it. You know, I'm going to ask you guys a lot of questions. I don't care if you're a renter, a buyer, a seller of a property, an investor of a property. I'm going to ask you a lot of questions to find out, number one, if you're serious and what I call if you're for real, you know, in the industry there. But I do practice safety. And so if you don't have the right answers to those questions there, then I may not be your best candidate for a realtor there. But I'm also going to ask you to check your ID potentially here to find out, like, hey, that you really are who you say you are, and husband and wife, you kind of live at the same address, or it all makes sense, that kind of thing. And you should not fear us asking you for that kind of information there. You're going to be releasing that information anyway when you go to the lender to get a loan. So be prepared for that. We might ask you if you have been pre-approved or pre-qualified with a lender. We might ask you for a copy of that lender letter. Be prepared to show that to us. On a lot of our properties here, particularly the higher end properties, you can't even get into a showing if you don't provide evidence of a lender approved letter or a bank letter stating, you know, that you have sufficient assets in your bank account as signed by the bank officer. So these are important, because these are precautions that everybody wants to enable and make sure that everybody is safe in the wonderful world of real estate. So keep on going out there, look for homes to buy, look for homes to rent, offer your homes for sale, look for homes to buy as an investment opportunities there. But just remember, play it safe. There is no sale to a buyer or a seller of a property, and certainly not to a realtor, that is worth jeopardizing your safety. That's it. Cheryl Garlock with Colorado Front Range Properties, and thank you for listening in.